Well, I'm sitting on my lunch break, grinning my teeth. It's the last day of the week, boy, what a relief. My muscles kinda ache, they felt rigid and stiff. So I looked around and I smoked this big fat split. Now I'm happy as can be, I'm in this my head spell. I put some visor in my eyes so that no one can tell. It's 12:55, almost time for the bell. Put the breakfast in the mouth so that the mouth don't smell. Now back on the job, I don't bother no one. I keep strictly to myself and all my work gets done. Now the job's finally over, it's time to have fun. And I'm hanging out with Jeff up as a kid named John. Y'all were drunker than a skunk and happy as can be. We went to the Latin quarters and we got in free. Scooping all the girls like nothing with my truck jewelry. Cause I'm a fly brown brother and you can't school me. Boogie Down was performing, hey, they ain't no joke. And a bunch of Brooklyn kids was looking all down my throat. Was it my big chains with the big plates on them? Then they rolled on me and told me to run them. This was the moment I feared.
Hey, yo, homeboy, take off your chains, man. About to hurt you real fucking bad.
This was the moment I feared.
No, it's matter, stupid. Take the shits off, man. The fuck's up?
I said they're really not real. They're just a front for the girls. Then a whole bunch of furious fists caved my world. I was in pain. So much shame. I wish I had not came. Had to kindly pick up my face and then fly home on the train. Then I went to an open store, that's where I brought me a quart. Then I went to the park and I sat and I thought, I seen Danny Boy Bluey's with his girl named Sarah in one of his cars. I think this one's up Rivera. She calls out to me, but I really couldn't hear her. So I went just a little bit closer so I'd hear a little clearer. She said,
I need Veronica Place, that's right near Tilden.
I said, I know where that's at, cause that's right next to my building. I gave them the information and they went on their way. I went home and there I slept till almost 3 the next day. Then someone knocked on my door. I opened up, no quit. It was Sarah with some magazines and a band-aid kit. She tried to use me and seduce me, and at first I wasn't with it. Then we did it, and we did it, and we did it, and we did it. She says it was great, she says she's glad we had done it. The elevator came and Danny Boy was on it. This was the moment I feared.
Hey yo, what the fuck's going on here? What you doing with my girl?
This was the moment I feared.
No, y'all ain't just finished fucking.
Billy was up in and puffing, and he swung at me.
Word.
So I pulled out my jammy and I silenced the nerd. Then he was dead too in the head. I took the cash and the visa. She said,
don't worry about a thing, just make sure nobody sees us.
We went back to her apartment, there was blowing the freezers. She said,
we're rich, we can have whatever will please us.
Now I don't hang with no one who ain't good for my health. So I put this little girl head out and I went for self. Now I was rich as I was rich, I could have whatever would please me. Now I could wear real gold in front of folks that would tease me. Y'all me, RD, a new neighborhood dad. Cats would roll up on me screaming,
yo, Rick, my man.
I guess I was too fly word up, I'm sorry to say. You see, a cop rolled up on me and told me,
make my day.
I said, relax, brother, but he had proof that I had done it. Y'all be had poor Sarah's underwear with my fingerprints all on it. This was the rise and fall of my fast lane style. And I was the main event on the TV for a while. But now I'm in jail doing life, and I'm scared. Some kids snuffed me cold and greased me when no one dared. This was the moment I feared.
Turn around.